Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to generate and manipulate the columns in .NET MAUI DataGrid. The DataGrid creates columns automatically based on the types of individual properties and also allows users to display only columns that have been manually defined in the view. You'll also see how to add columns to the DataGrid at runtime, access a column via its column index, and remove columns. I'm using the Getting Started example application that was pre-configured with the necessary DataGrid namespace and data. You can download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description. You can also watch the Getting Started video I've shared in the YouTube card. Now, I'll run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the column width is not suitable for the header text. So, I add the column width mode property and set its value to fit by header. I run the example. And you can see the column width changed to match the header text. As I said, the data grid creates columns automatically. To show this, I modify the custom fields in the defined model class named OrderInfo with appropriate data types. Then, I assign values to these fields. I open the View Model class, OrderInfo repo, and generate orders with defined properties. Once that's done, save the changes and run the example. Looking here, the MAUI data grid control is displayed with different columns, and the table shows the column types created for different data types. Next, let me show you how to customize the automatically generated columns. First, invoke the auto-generating column event in the data grid. To keep the customer named column from being automatically generated, check if the column mapping name is customer. If it is, set cancel to true. See, the customer column is no longer displayed. Next, to format the text displayed in the shiptime column, I check the condition where the column mapping name is shiptime and format it by setting MMMYY. Now, only the month and year are displayed in the shiptime column. Finally, to show the header text with spacing, check the condition for each column's mapping name and modify the header text. Okay, the changes are done. Let me run the application. You can see the header text changed. Now, let me show you how to define the columns manually in a data grid. For that, I define the auto-generate columns mode property and set its value to none. By setting this property, you can create different column types and add it to the columns collection. No data is displayed because no column has been generated. Multiple column types are available in the data grid control. To display columns, define the columns collections. First, I add a data grid numeric column to display the order IDs. Let me set the mapping name property to order ID and header text to order ID. Next, I add a data grid text column to display customer names. Set the mapping name property and header text to customer. Then, add a data grid checkbox column to determine whether or not the orders have been shipped. Next, I set the mapping name property to isShipped and header text to isShipped. I save these changes and run the application. Looking here, the data grid generates only the defined columns. If you want to learn about different types of columns in a data grid, you can find the information in the documentation link provided in the description. Now, let me show you how to manipulate columns by adding, deleting, etc. For runtime changes, I set a name to the data grid to get columns in code behind. Next, add a new button that manipulates columns with its clicked event. First, I add a column to the data grid, I create a new instance of the data grid text column, and set the mapping name property to ship country and header text to ship country. Add it to the Data Grid Columns collection. The data grid shows only three columns. Now, I click the button. You can see a new column for ship country displayed. Next, insert the ship country column in the first index. Run the example. And click the button. Looking here, the ship country column is displayed in the second column of the data grid. Next, I will show how to access a column in the data grid. First, get the column by its index or mapping name from the columns collection. For example, I will get the second column by its index. And change its header text to client. I save these changes and run the application. I click the button. Look, the header text is changed. And now, we will see how to remove a column. I get the order ID column in the columns collection by comparing the mapping name. Then, simply remove it from the data grid columns collection. Initially, the data grid shows three columns. When I click the button, you will see the order ID column no longer displayed in the data grid. Next, you can remove the first column by its index using the remove_at method. Save these changes and run the application. Once loaded, click the button. Looking here, the first column is removed from the data grid. You can also remove all the columns in a data grid by using the clear method directly. Save this change and run the application. After it is loaded, click the button. And you will see all the columns removed. In this video, I have shown you how to generate and manipulate columns in the .NET MAUI Data Grid Control. I also showed you how to generate columns automatically and manually, and how to add, access, and remove columns. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I've also included a link where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you for watching.